Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed and the twilight's last gleaming whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring, ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our rejoicing rise high as the listening skies. Let it resound loud as the rolling sea. Sing a song full of the faith that the dark past has taught us. Sing a song full of the hope that the present has brought us. Facing the rising sun of our new day begun, let us march on till victory is won. Stony the road we tried, bitter the chastening rod, felt in the days when hope unborn had died. Yet with the steady come to the place for which our Father sighed. We have come over a way that with tears has been watered. We have come treading our path through the blood of the slaughtered. Out from the till now we stand at last where the white gleam of our bright star is cast. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, thou who has brought us thus far on the way, thou who has brought to the light, keep us forever in the path, we pray. Lest our feet stray from the places, our God, where we met thee, lest our heart, drunk with the wine of the world, we forget thee. Shadow beneath thy hand, may we forever stand true to our God, true to our native land.
My name is Dwayne Eason, and I am the proud principal of Southfield Regional Academic Campus. Before I get started, let's take our mindful moment. Stop what you're doing. Take a deep breath. Observe what's happening in and around you, and then we will proceed with the ceremony. I typically give my graduation speech with the Detroit River behind me, my fellow administrators and colleagues next to me, and all of the graduates in front of me, eager for that moment when they can celebrate the end of their senior year. In years past, I would have used this time to give words of wisdom and share advice with all of you for the next chapter of your lives. However, as you all know by now, this graduation ceremony is definitely unique. Instead of me speaking to you in person, I am speaking to you from my home. Now, we navigated the remainder of this school year virtually, and it has truly been a paradigm shift for not just all of you, but also your teachers and your families as we work together to provide distance learning opportunities for all of you. When the pandemic hit, causing students and staff to transition to following the statewide stay-at-home order, it was truly epic. Some of you may have thought to yourselves, this is great. Perhaps you thought you would not be required to complete work when you were, or like when you were in the building. You may have believed that no longer would you have to listen to your teachers go on and on about your assignments and responsibilities in your various classes. Some of you may have even had a moment of personal celebration when you realized that you no longer had to wake up at 5 a.m. to catch the 6 a.m. bus. Yes, for many of you, the announcement was life-changing. However, very shortly after schools transitioned to distant learning, your phones began to ring. Sure enough, it was either your teacher, your counselor, or me checking on you and your family to make sure you were all safe and doing well. Once the staff and I felt assured that you were okay, our conversations transitioned, and yes, we resumed our discussions about your assignments and responsibilities, just like we used to do when you were with us in the building. Not only did we speak about your assignments, but we also informed you of your scheduled Zoom and Google Hangout meetings. As French philosopher Henry Bergson once said, to exist is to change. To change is to mature. To mature is to go on creating oneself endlessly. See, the world in an instant changed, and you changed with the world. I commend you on how you adapted to the change in your educational life. Now that we are beginning to transition people back into the workforce, we are experiencing episodes of social injustice and protests due to civil unrest and racism. It's almost as if you are living in your grandparents' era where protest and social injustice were hailed to bring attention to issues that were long overdue for a change. These recent events have brought to light the need for change to address not just nationwide health issues, but also the impact of racism and bias has had on citizens in the United States. Therefore, as Superintendent Dr. Green stated, it is now incumbent on all of us to continue to create the community we want for all of our children. Class of 2020, your voices and actions are going to help the world understand how people should be treated from this day forward. I have much more to say, but today, your Southfield Regional staff want to celebrate you for your tenacity and your ability to still persevere during this unprecedented time. We are truly sad that we can't give your traditional hugs and signs of affection due to the much needed social distancing measures. But please know we still wish you the very best and care about each and every one of you. You can be the change we wish to see in the world, Gandhi has said, as Gandhi has said. And as Steve Jobs, co-founder of Apple, stated, the people who are crazy enough to think they can change the world are the ones who do. And that should be you. Class of 2020, you are a vision of hope, of promise, and respect. Promise yourself and your loved ones you will lead the charge to make the change for a better future for us all. One way to lead that charge to make a change is to get out and vote on November 3rd. I leave you with a virtual hug and congratulations, graduates.
Hello, class of 2020, families and friends. My name is Felicia Sells Powell, and I am one of the science teachers at Southfield Regional, and I've also had the opportunity to serve as a class sponsor for this school year. I wanted to take this opportunity to congratulate all of you for all of your hard work, the commitment and dedication and the resilience that you've shown over the past few months. We are also proud of you, and we need you to continue to follow your dreams and be that beacon of hope that we all need in this time. Thank you, and congratulations again.
Hi, graduates. It's Mr. Harris. I wanted to tell you guys congratulations. Good job staying focused, getting this work done, turning it in so you can go ahead and graduate high school. I want to wish you nothing but success in your future. And again, congratulations. Job well done, guys.
Hi everyone, my name is Tiffany Johnson and I'm a teacher at Southfield Regional Academic Campus. I just want to wish the seniors graduating 2020 congratulations and best wishes for the future. Bye.
Regional students, this is Ms. Cook and I just want to say that I am extremely proud of each and every one of you. I'm sure there were times where you felt like quitting, like this is too difficult, but you did not. You persevered, you kept going, even though these times are challenging. I wanna let each and every one of you know that I am extremely proud of you from the bottom of my heart. Take care.
Seniors, I am truly going to miss all of you. But I want you all to remember these words throughout life. Behind you are all of your memories. Before you are all of your dreams. Around you are all of the people who love you dearly. But always remember, within you is all you need to be successful. Congratulations, class of 2020. I love you guys. Bye, Mrs. Chapman.
Hello, I am Ms. EJ. First and foremost, allow me to be one of many to congratulate and salute you for all of your amazing academic accomplishments. You are still young champions, ready to transcend the obstacles and invent new and better traditions and ways to celebrate together. In the midst of these trying times, it is important to pause and acknowledge your resilience, intellect, and grit. Congratulations to the class of 2020. Love you.
Hey guys, this is Mr. Cuthrell from Southfield Regional Academic Campus. I want to congratulate the class of 2020. Whether you killed it and were a valedictorian or you had to make that amazing comeback as a credit recovery student, hats off to you. The next chapter begins now. And what you do from here, GPA start over. Everything is a fresh start. So go ahead and make your future what you want it to be. Once again, congratulations.
Hello, class of 2020. This is Miss Brown Perkins, lovingly known as Miss BP. Congratulations. I am so excited for you. I am very happy that you have accomplished one of many major milestones. Each of you are fabulous and talented in your own way. And I am going to be very excited to see you again in the future as you continue to fulfill your future dreams. See you soon. With love, Miss BP.
Class of 2020, today marks the beginning of anything you want. Over the years, you've made continuous small steps in the right direction, which now leads you to endless possibilities. You have come so far, and your teachers, your parents, and your counselors are so proud of you. So each day that you're blessed with breath in your body, no matter how you feel, I want you to get up, show up, and most importantly, never give up. As you graduate today, you now have a non-negotiable responsibility to change the world. And I'll leave you with a message that my mother taught me many years ago. Don't judge. Show up early. Be kind. Honor those who have gone before you. And in doing these, you'll not only be blessed, but more importantly, you'll be a blessing to other people. Congratulations. Now go out there and change the world. Peace.
Hello, family and friends. I am Cheyenne McEvans, the valedictorian for the graduating class of 2020. First and foremost, I want to congratulate my fellow graduates. Although our senior year was cut short and our final chapter wasn't written the way we thought, all in all, we made it. It is the hard times that push us to be greater, and great we are. I would like to take this opportunity to thank everyone who has been there to motivate me along the way. I started in Southfield Public Schools as a nervous kindergartner at McIntyre Elementary School, moved to MacArthur as a naive fifth grader, and here I stand as a confident graduate of Southfield High School for the Arts and Technology. I have been blessed to have had supportive coaches, teachers, counselors, and peers. Basketball has made me confident, and that would not have been possible without great coaches. Coach Marshall, throughout my career with you as my coach, we have gained and had to overcome plenty of haters. Together we have lived the words of Psalm 23:5, Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. We were blessed with the strength that allowed us to push through our challenges so we could receive blessings. To all of my other coaches, thank you for having the faith in me to lead. Great teachers motivate their students to be the best version of themselves. When I was discouraged, I could always count on Mrs. Walker, Mrs. Biondo, or Ms. Felix Brown for reassurance. Thank you for being patient. To my counselors, thank you for listening and having my back through uneasy situations. I could always count on Mrs. Johnson and Ms. Calloway to make it happen. To my friends, thank you for being there to lift me up when I was down. To my family, my support system, my backbone, thank you for filling me with love even when I had little to none to give back. To my mom, thank you for molding me into the independent young lady that I am. Without you, I would not be here today. Finally, I want to thank God for every obstacle, every challenge, and every good moment along with the bad. With God, all things are possible. As most of you may know, basketball is my life. From the age of 5, I have been playing basketball. I come from a sports family, so I have always been around it. I never imagined what my life would be like without basketball until the summer following my freshman year of high school. I was playing in a basketball game like the hundreds I've played in before, and I broke my leg. I didn't know when or if I would be able to play again. Everything I had been working so hard for was suddenly snatched away. I was scared and anxious, wondering if I would be able to pick up where I left off or would I have to start all over. Wondering what life would hold for me, if my dreams of playing college basketball were over. Wondering if my life would ever be the same. This senior year has been a lot like the time when I broke my leg. COVID-19 came out of nowhere and snatched away all of the moments that we were looking forward to. No prom, no Grammys, no senior skip days, no water wars, not even a real graduation. The world stopped just as we were about to dive into the best part of our senior year. We are frustrated, sad, anxious, and even angry. Despite it all, I am so proud of the class of 2020. Through the disappointment, we are taking everything in stride. Like we always do, we adjust. Staying positive, sticking together, and making the most of the circumstances. Just like I got back out on the court stronger than before, we have used this experience to make us better students and better people. We embrace the journey and the obstacles that came with it and are stronger because of it. The challenges of our senior year taught us to persevere, be resilient, optimistic, and to never take things for granted. Class of 2020, real life is around the corner. In just a few months, we'll be starting a new chapter in our life. Whether attending a university, trade school, or joining the workforce, know that you are strong. You are prepared. You are ready. I am proud of us, and I know that we will accomplish great things. The best is yet to come. Remember, it is the hard times that push us to be great. Congratulations, class of 2020.
To the Southfield Board of Education, parents, community partners, administrators, teachers, staff, and volunteers of the Southfield Public School District, I would like to say thank you. Thank you for the service you have given to our academic scholars and the many other students that attend our magnificent school district. This commencement ceremony is a time to relish the fruits of our past achievements, a time to set new goals, and a time to renew our commitment to ourselves and to those values that make us intelligent, beautiful, gifted, and diverse people that we are. This ceremony also serves to remind us of how closely our lives are intertwined and how much certain people mean to us. For as we honor you today, no one made it here to this point on their own without support. At this time, I would like to ask the parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, and guardians of the honorees to please stand and be recognized. Everyone, let's give them a round of applause to show them our appreciation for their hard work and unwavering support. Thank you, and please be seated. No matter how high you climb on the ladder of life, your parents, grandparents, guardian, and family will always be there watching, assessing, nurturing, and ensuring that you represent them with dignity, strength, and the compassion by which you were raised. So today, as we gather to honor your achievements, I would like to take the liberty to express our past generation's confidence in each and every one of you. The world in which you are passing is one cast with shadows. I say that not to frighten you, but to challenge you as you move forward in your continued pursuit of excellence. Marcus Aurelius, a Roman emperor, said it best when giving advice to his children about striking out on their own. He said, "Everything we hear is an opinion, not a fact. And everything we see is perspective, not truth." Marcus Garvey said, "Intelligence rules the world, and ignorance carries the burden." Or perhaps you can relate best to a message from a mom. "There is greatness in all of us. Dare to discover your greatness, because life is the sum of our choices." At times, your pursuit of self may lead you far from home. And at times, you will feel as if you don't belong. But remember, home is where the heart is. It is where your passion takes you. Your education, family, and faith is the source of your strength that will sustain you through all of the hardships to come. And as you continue on your path, you will lose some friends and gain new ones. The process will prove to be painful, but often necessary. They will change, and you will change, simply because the only thing in life that is constant is change. From time to time, they must find their way, and that way may not be yours. So enjoy them for who they are and remember them for what they were. Don't confuse popularity with your purpose. The light that shines in you is greater than the light that shines on you. I challenge you today to see in the adversities in life the challenge to excel and not the excuse for failure. I challenge you today to see in the battles that lie ahead, the fires that will forge strength and greatness, and not the flames that destroy hope and dreams. I challenge you today to see in life ahead the wonders unfolding of providence, and not the fate of the trapped and disadvantaged. You are children of the universe, no greater than the less fortunate, and no less than the heavenly stars. You have earned the right to be honored here today. And whether or not it's clear to you at this moment, have no doubt that the universe is unfolding as it should, and your rightful place among the mighty legends of your great ancestry has been preordained. Sooner or later, no matter how difficult times will appear to be, it will all work out if you employ the eyes, integrity, ingenuity, and intelligence. The road is never easy. It was never meant to be. But in the long run, if you stay true to what you believe in, things will work out. Always be willing to fight for what you believe in. It doesn't matter if one or 1,000 people disagree with you. It doesn't matter if you stand completely alone. Fight for what you believe in. Fight for your education and the pursuit of excellence. Dare to discover the greatness in you. It's wonderful that others believe in you, but it's everything that you believe in yourself. Today, I am here with the village that has raised you and humbled by having the pleasure of sharing this time of honor and recognition of your accomplishments. You have the encouragement and support of past generations to rise to the level of greatness from which we all hail. So as I close, I leave you with a quote from Sidney J. Harris, an American journalist with the Chicago Sun-Times, who said, "The purpose of education is to turn mirrors into windows." So I say to you, the sons and daughters of the Southfield Public Schools, we honor you today and send you forth with prayers to turn your mirrors into windows of opportunities. Dare to discover the greatness in you. Congratulations, class of 2020.
As the principal of Southfield High School for the Arts and Technology, I bring greetings on behalf of our faculty and staff. On this day, we assemble to celebrate the accomplishments of the phenomenal class of 2020 and to acknowledge the family, friends, staff, and community partners who supported our students along the way. We share a common purpose to honor each and every one of our seniors for fulfilling the state of Michigan and Southfield Public Schools graduation requirements with their cohort. This ceremonial procedure is a school tradition saluting the completion of a 12-year academic journey that our students successfully completed. However, there was nothing traditional or even typical about your high school experience, especially your senior year. The plight that COVID-19 caused our society as a whole could have taken this victory away from within your grasp, but it didn't. It couldn't, because you are a warrior and your fight for victory was too mighty to be defeated. Not only did you survive high school, you survived a pandemic and you won. You are still standing and you still graduated from high school in the midst of tragedy, hardship, uncertainty, and drastic change, which indicates that you are unstoppable. When you think back on this time in your life and COVID comes to mind, I want you to remember COVID as claim our victory instead of defeat. Repeat it with me. Claim our victory instead of defeat. No one ever promised that life would be easy, as evidenced by your journey, but your life is what you make of it. COVID-19 didn't make you a victim. It served as a life lesson that no matter what obstacles come your way, you will get through it, and like a warrior, you will win. In addition to the life lesson, your experience forced us all to be creative, to think outside of the norm, and to honor and celebrate the class of 2020 in a way that has never been done before. Instead of the ordinary ceremonial rituals that had been done over and over again, the year of 2020 earmarked a time for change. Whether it was voluntary or not, our extraordinary class of 2020 served as the trailblazers for our nation to rethink how we honor millennials and how we celebrate you. From the personal home visits with awards and gifts to surprise our 27 top scholars who maintained a 3.5 cumulative GPA and higher throughout their entire high school career, to participating in a celebratory caravan to acknowledge our valedictorian at her home and our salutatorian who was at her job working when we came to personally acknowledge her excellence in education, to faculty and staff members making wellness calls to connect with families in need, and departments visiting the homes of students celebrating their triumphant victory against the odds and earning certificates of completion, from creating videos that make you retain as keepsakes reminding you that your warrior family matters, to nationwide celebrations of graduates with remarks from speeches from celebrities, professional athletes, and our former president, Barack Obama, from diploma processions and caravans of cars saluting our seniors in the city of Southfield, to this virtual graduation ceremony that you can keep and access whenever desired and share with generations to come. Class of 2020, you forced others and yourselves to disrupt the status quo, to go higher when things got low, to forgo tradition and start anew, and to change for the better, which we did because we love you. I bid farewell to the class of 2020 as I introduce your 12th grade principal, Mr. Jason Solomon.
Hello, class of 2020. First, I want to say congratulations on accomplishing your goal of graduating from high school with your peers. If there is a lesson that you should have learned from this global pandemic that was caused by COVID-19, it is that time is a precious commodity. From this day forward, make sure that you maximize every second, every hour, and every day of your time for the rest of your life. I also encourage you to look at your time in Southfield A&T and reflect on your accomplishments and your failures, because they both have prepared you for life after high school. But now is the time to set new goals, because as you can see, the world and your community needs engineers, we need scientists, medical professionals, teachers, judges, first responders, and most importantly, we need community activists that have the same values and morals as you. So now is the time to realize your greatness and to do what is necessary to leave a positive footprint on the world and your community. Again, congratulations for graduating from high school, but be mindful that your journey is just beginning. There's an old saying, to whom much is given, much is expected. Your family, your friends, and your warrior family have given you their best. And now we expect you to realize your greatness and make the changes that are needed in the world today. I love you, and I look forward to talking with you about how you have made a positive impact on the world.
4 years ago, we started this journey together. You, incoming freshman, broken into cohorts in Old House. Me, a first-year counselor with a classroom as an office. I remember your ninth grade year like it was yesterday. That was the year I formed bonds with many of you. That year I formed bonds that will never be broken. When we started this journey together, there was a theme of Imagine 2020. Do y'all remember that? Imagine 2020. Who would have ever thought it would be like this? I never imagined that I would be sitting here on your graduation day this way, but here we are. There are just a couple things that I want to share with you. For those of you who spent any amount of time with me in my office, you've already probably heard these things. But here we go. The first thing is that you can do it. Whatever the road is that is in front of you, you have already shown that you have resilience and overcoming spirit, that you are strong, and that you can conquer anything. You all have had to face so many challenges throughout these 4 years, but you stuck with it. For many of you, this journey was not easy. I've seen you have growing pains and push through. You have already shown that you have whatever it takes to handle whatever this world has to throw at you. This brings me to my next point. You are in the driver's seat of your life. You have the ultimate control of your next steps, what you will do as an occupation, whether or not you go to school, how well you do in school. Do not allow someone else to take the wheel. Your future is bright. The world is yours. Do your best. Live life to the fullest. Be better than average. Be exceptional. I can't wait to hear all of your accomplishments. Lastly, I am so very proud of each and every one of you. I love you all from the bottom of my heart. I will cherish the memories that we have had together, the laughter and even the tears. I will truly miss each and every one of you. Thank you for allowing me to be a part of your life and for letting me in. You all will always hold a special place in my life. Now, we will hear from your senior board class president, Benjamin Cody.
Good afternoon, parents, siblings, families, administrators, friends, teachers, and last but not least, the graduating class of 2020. I am Benjamin Colding, president of the class board, and it is an honor to speak for you all right now. Now, I know our world is in a crisis with this virus, but despite this, I must acknowledge the class of 2020 properly, so don't mind if I don't mention, you know who, Corona Lachey the virus. Before I get deep into this thud-inducing, dazzling quote, I'd love to give a shout out to my family and my girlfriend, Nia Ray, along with her family, for the Echols, for all of the love, support, and hospitality. Now, I like to recite my all-time favorite quote from the anime, Mob Psycho 100, your life is your own. Now, all year, I've acquired a solid knowledge about college and heard about how it's going to dip into my wallet and everything, and I've decided the University of Michigan, Ann Arbor, home of the Wolverines, will be my new place to thrive, only with the full ride, of course. But during this long, patience-testing, eye-opening senior year, I've seen that this isn't everyone's decision. Not everyone is going to college, trade school, or any form of a secondary education, and this is fine. Like a sophisticated tree sprouting into the sky, life has many paths, obstacles, and end results. Like squirrels shooting up a tree, we all may start together in life, part ways, go the same route, and break off, or maybe even go the same way as someone else. Electing to go into the workforce and get that bread, get a bag, and make that cash doesn't make you lesser than or better than. It's just doing what you think is best. If you have an obligation to serve our nation for the duration of your days, then do so. If you want to study crustaceans in the Haitian water, study the annexation of a nation, or look at a human's blood circulation, then do so. Your life is your own, and only you live it. Each and every graduate, special and aspiring for greatness, has a set of morals that they abide by, a sense of content that they stand by, and a dream that they seek to achieve. So to each and every graduate, I say, your life is your own. Do what makes you happy. Do what makes you feel fulfillment. Do what keeps you stable and able to be grateful that you live the life that you have. Face the future with the feistiness that we face high school and bring your dreams to fruition. Remember, your life is your own.
Delaney Adams. DeJohn Agee. Andrian Akins. Ahmad Alkrad. Mohammed Alkrad. Autumn Allen. Darius Allen. Jayla Allen. Samuel Allen. Takia Allen. Charles Allen Jr. Nabwizi Amanzi. Smalen Angelus Kaba. Jalen Apicanis, Taurus Arms,
everybody have successful lives.
Alexia Armstrong, Madison Armstrong, Spencer Armstrong, Jada Arrington, Kaimea Ashford, Alfrenique Aspinall, Jeffrey Atkins Jr., Bryce Austin, Deontay Austin, Ramatule Bay, Dion Bailey, Stephen Bailiff.
My name is Stephen Bailiff. I just want to thank all the friends and family I've had up to now to push me to be who I am today. I want to do graphic design and music production.
Kennedy Baldwin, Mecky Ballard, Junia Barnes, Sherlyn Barragan, Keila Barrett, Anaya Baxter.
Hi, I just want to thank my friends, my family for supporting me throughout this journey. And I just want to say that I am so grateful and I'm so happy. Thank you. You made it.
Kyla Beckwith, Solomon Bell, Paige Bell Johnson, Martinez Blanche, Kashawn Bonds Jr., Jasmine Bradley, Lauren Bradley, Christopher Bright, Brooke Bright Jordan, Teron Britton, Naja Brooks, Orlando Brooks, Peta Shea Brooks, Alexis Brown, Amari Brown, Jarius Brown, Deshaun Bundridge, Martez Burnett, Danielle Burns, Tommy Burns III, Sydney Burrell, Lisa Butler, Joseph Bybee, Kyle Calloway, Damian Kaneda Jr., Jayla Carr, Damaje Carson, Deondrick Carson, Jeremiah Carter, Jocelyn Carter, Tyson Carter, Brooklyn Carter Bouye, Elijah Case, Chantel Chambers, Landon Chambers, Brianna Chapman, Tiana Chapman, Taryn Clark, Rochelle Clay, Keon Cleary, Daquan Coach, Damian Cochran, Benjamin Colding, Jamie Cole, Destiny Collins, Treasure Collins, Alicia Compton, Carlos Correa, Trayana Cotton, Jamier Cruz, Dylan Krigler, Malachi Crum, Kaylee Cryer, Quinton Cummings, Desmond Curry, Shanti Daggins, William Daniels, Seneca Daniels Jr., Surendra Dasgupta, Naya Davenport, Alea Davis, Darian Davis, Kiera Davis, Sean Davis, Carrie Dawkins, Camila Dawkins, Devian Dick, Kyron Dickerson, Mika Dyke, Demetrius Dillard, Damonte Dillard, Jeremiah Dixie, Tavion Dobbs, Quanadre Drake, Dijon Duncan, Nia Eccles, Eric Edmond, Desmond Edmondson, Simeon Egwafobe Jr., Itohan Enabulele, Charity English, Mackenzie Falls, Madison Falls, Kristen E. Finley, Darius Ford, Jaden Ford, Kari Fouché, Philip France, Michael Franklin III, Omarion Freeman, James Fulton IV, Fallon Fultz, Ashanti Galloway, Asaya Galloway, DeAndre Gamble.
My name is DeAndre. I am graduating from Southfield A&T. I'd like to thank my friends and family for being on me with this journey, and I'm going to Full Sail University to be a music producer.
Jalen Garrett. Miracle Gary. Imare Gilbert.
Congratulations, 2020. Woo!
Yara Giles. Anthony Gill. Denijah Guignard. Jalen Glover. Amelia Goodwin. Raven Grace. Kerry Graham. Maya Graves. Jordan Green. Kalon Green. Joshua Green. Aaliyah Griffin. Taiwan Griffith. Maram Guy. Devante Geese. Kayla Guilford. Hunter Hall. Jordan Hall. Nefertari Harrelson. Donovan Hardy. Jamar Harmon. Paris Harper. Warren Harper. Cardia Harris. Dijanelle Harris. Fallon Harris. Diamond Harrison. Donald Hatcher III. Justin Helms. Caleb Herdman. Davina Herring. Elise Hill. Paul Hill. Ramaya Hill. Tanija Hill. Jillian Hobbs. Gerald Hogan III. Colin Holder. Lawrence Howard. Joseph Hudgens Lopez. Rashid Hunter. Dorian Hersey. Patrick Ingram. LaRon Irby. Courtney Jackson. Hawaii Jackson. Joey Jackson. Maceo Jackson. Terica Jackson. Charlie James. Willie James. Nyambu Jame. Reginald Jenkins Jr. Angel Johnson. Brandy Johnson. Dwayne Johnson. Jalen Johnson.
Jalen Johnson here. I would like to thank my family, my parents, and my friends for the support and the encouragement throughout my entire senior year. I will later be pursuing my career through the Army in cybersecurity.
Javon Johnson. Carrion Johnson. Madison Johnson. Sierra Johnson.
Hi, class of 2020. This is Sierra Johnson. I want to say thank you, Mom, for everything you have done for me through high school. And class of 2020, we did it.
Aaron Jones. Angel Jones. David Jones. Joshua Jones. Leon Jones. Logan Jones. Orlando Jones. Taylor Jordan. Destiny Joyce. Marquis Joyner. Michael Kalu. Darius Keaton Jr. Kyla Kenny. Michael Keys. Winter Keys. Naya King. Rashad King.
I really hate that all this stuff in the world is happening right now, because 9th and 10th and 11th grade, I was in and out of Saturday and summer school, but I really just want to thank my mom and my dad.
Markeisha King Barber. Marvin Knight Jr. Rashad Lambert. Aaron Langdon. Jack Lawson. Troy Lawson Jr. Jalen Lee. Javian Lee. Marcella Lee. Marche Lee. Summer Lee. Alexandria Legarty. Joseph Lesneski. Michael Lewis. Shania Lewis. Breeson Lilly. Dejon Linnebarger. Destiny Little. Jaden Littlefield Davis.
Jaden Littlefield Davis, just want to thank my parents, counselors, principals, teachers, coaches, everybody that helped me get to the point where I am now. And we graduated, we made it. Thank you.
Tiana Lloyd. Alaysia Lockett. Carrie Lofton. Eli Lofton. Michaela Lovelace. Jessica Marks. Courtney Marsh. Christian Martin. Ginger Martinez. Tyrell Martin Springer. Christina Mason. Dylan Mason. Javian Mason. Lanaya Mason. Haley Massey. Dwayne Maton Jr. Noah Matson Bose. Carew Maxwell. Brandon Maxwell Jr. Landon McAllister. Mark Anthony McCullough. Jaden McRae. Ashanti McDaniel. Raymond McDonald. Cheyenne McEvans. Kelly McFadden. Jalen McGee Goff. Sangria McGoff. Kevin McGowan. Samaj McKeever. Delana Melanson. Daviana Mitchell. Eric Mitchell. Tasia Moore. Sasha Moorer. Tiana Morris. Tyler Morris. Destiny Moss. Shardaya Moss. Ashamoy Mullings. Jasmine Merton. Jordan Nash. Emmanuel Micah Neal. Kamaya Nelson. Michael Nelson. Morgan Nelson. Toriona Nelson. Jalen Nicholson. Jayla Nicholson. Musona Nukulu. Nia Norman. Sharia Norris. Genesis Norris. Stephanie Nuagu. Adrian Wanye. Mwaninwola Olarunshala. Oluwadarasimi Olarunshala. Sylvia Onyebule. Gerald Page. Alonza Palmer. Jalen Parker. Travon Payton. Kaylin Peace. Jasmine Perkins. Jade Perry. K. Kimberly Pham, Jordan Phillips, Jeremiah Piper, Aaliyah Poole, Justin Price Jr., Daniel Pruett Burden, Bentley Pruett, Jameel Randall, Chase Rapley, Jayla Reese, Keith Reed Jr., David Reese, Chloe Rembert, Randall Reno Jr., Lauren Revel, Tyler Ryer, Chancellor Reynolds, William Rice, Koyana Rice Cutts, Jamie Richards, Armad Robinson, Ashani Robinson.
With it, I'ma show you how to get it. It go right foot up, left foot slide. Left foot up, right foot slide. Basically, I'm saying either way, we about to slide. Can't let this one slide.
Machea Robinson. Riley Robinson.
Yo, what's poppin', everybody? It's your girl, Ryan, to the class 2020. We did that. I just want to thank my mom and dad for paying for all my multiple activities. To my friends, y'all know who y'all are. And to my papa, I love you. I did it.
Tatiana Robinson. Alante Roland. Caleb Russell. Rosemary Sadiq. Sandra Salmon. Kayla Sampson. Jordan Samuel. Tariq Samuel. Arthur Samuels. Jaywan Samuels. Demarian Sanchez. Anthony Sanders. Lee Scott Jr. Armani Sharp. Savian Shaver. Michaela Silas. Ruth Sims. Malik Sims. Jalen Slack. Jordan Slack. Leah Slayton. Anaya Smith. Jordan Smith. Christopher Smith. Naya Smith. Star Smith. Samantha Smith Bay. Nevaeh Smith Fagan. Malik Snipes. Javion Sorrell. Ashley Spicer. Janiah Starks. William Strickland. Antoine Stroman. Enevi Sykes. Darius Tarrant. Javon Taylor. Queen Makita Taylor.
I just want to say thank you to all the teachers and faculty and everyone. Thank you so much.
Teray Taylor. Corey Teasley. Lola Thibodeau. Ashaw Thomas. Aaron Thomas. Tavare Thomas. Ashayla Thompson. Jada Tisdale. Na Tran. Dion Trailer II. Madison Turner. Destiny Twyman. Koye Tyler. Sharday Tyler. Ugochi Ubi. Marlon Union. Kevin Valentine. Courtney Van Cleve. Torian Vaughn. Jeremiah Walden. Antonio Walker. Kyra Walker. Candace Walker. Tania Walker. Malik Walls. Kobe Walton. Ariana Washington. Jalen Washington. Shemiah Washington. Arthur Watkins III. Jocelyn Watson. Kyra Waters. Joseph Weaver. Darnell Webb. Malaysia Webb. Serenity Webb. Kiana Weems. Kaylin Wells. Kayla Wesley. Alexis West.
So pretty.
You're so pretty.
Amani West. John West. Sanaya Westbrook. Diamond White. Kaya White. Raheem White. Jason White Jr. Alexander Whitman Crutcher. Danasia Wiggins. Ariel Williams. Sierra Williams. Danielle Williams. David Williams.
Hi, my name is David Williams. I am thankful for my family and friends for this special occasion, and I will be attending Focus Open Apprenticeship Program for his IT program.
Della Williams. Devin Williams. Janae Williams. Javon Williams. Joshua Williams. Taylor Williams. Mario Williamson Mitchell. Alana Willis. Taja Willis. Jayshawn Willis Young.
I want to thank God first, and I'm going to thank my family and my parents, and I will be attending MSU. Peace out, 2020.
Amer Wilson. Devin Wilson. Winston Wilson. Javari Womack. Destiny Woolen. Jasmine Worthy. Samuel Wyatt Jr. Coron York. Mariah Young.
Southfield High School for the Arts and Technology and Southfield Regional Academic Center Class of 2020. Please rise.
By the power vested in me by the Board of Education and
by the power vested in me by the state of Michigan, we hereby confer the diplomas of graduation with all the rights and privileges pertaining thereto.
In order to be official graduates of the class of 2020, there is just one thing left to do.
In order to culminate your high school graduation, Please move your tassel from right to left. I now pronounce you graduates of the Southfield Public School District. Congratulations.
On behalf of the trustees of the Southfield Board of Education, I want to congratulate you all for your achievement. We hope that you continually to grow and achieve within every field of human endeavor you so choose. We apologize and are sorry to have all the things that we've gone through, but we know that this has just made you just stronger so that you can move forward and be productive in whatever things you choose to pursue. Again, congratulations.